ask you about a certain situation, about a metaphor, actually, you spoke on the ground. What you mean by that? What the ground represent?
The ground is going to open up and swallow the evil. Wow. That's how I see it. My world is born. I see, and the ground is a symbol for the poor people.
Right.
The poor people is going to open up this whole world and swallow up the rich people. Because the rich people are going to be so fat, and they're going to be so appetizing. You know what I'm saying? Wealthy, appetizing. The poor people are so poor.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be like, you know, there might be some cannibalism out this month. They might eat the rich.
Alright, so let me ask you this then. Do you see yourself as somebody that's rich or somebody that made the best of their own opportunities?
I see myself as a natural born hustler, a true hustler in every sense of the word. I took nothing, I took the opportunities. I worked at the most menial and degrading job and built myself up so I could get it to where I owned it. I went from having somebody manage me to me hiring the person that works my management company. I changed everything. I realized my destiny in a matter of 5 years, you know what I'm saying? I made myself a millionaire. I made millions for a lot of people. Now it's time to make millions for myself, you know what I'm saying? I made millions for the record companies. I made millions for these movie companies. Now I make millions for us.
Through your different avenues of success, how would you say you managed to keep a level of sanity?
By my faith in God, by my faith in the game, and by my faith in all good things come to those that stay true.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And it was happening to me for a reason. You know what I'm saying? I was noticing shit. I was punching the right buttons. And it was happening. So it's no problem. You know, I mean, it's a problem, but I'm not going to let them know. I'm going to go straight through.
Would you consider yourself a fighter at heart, or somebody that only reacts when their back is against the wall?
Shit, I like to think that in every opportunity I've ever been threatened with resistance, it's been met with resistance. And not only me, but it goes down my family tree. You know what I'm saying? It's in my veins to fight back.
All right, well, how long do you think it take before niggas be like, fighting a war, I can't win, and I want to lay it all down?
In this country, a black man only have like 5 years we can exhibit maximum strength. And that's right now, while you're a teenager, while you're still strong, while you still want to lift weights, while you still want to shoot back. Because once you turn 30, it's like they take the heart and soul out of a man, out of a black man in this country, and you don't want to fight no more. And if you don't believe me, you can look around, you don't see no loudmouth 30-year-old motherfuckers.
That's crazy. Because me being one of your offsprings of the legacy you left behind, I can truly tell you that it's nothing but turmoil going on. So I want to ask you, what you think is the future for me and my generation today?
I think that niggas is tired of grabbing shit out the stores, and next time it's a riot, it's gonna be like bloodshed, for real. I don't think America know that. I think America think we was just playing. It's gonna be some more playing, but it ain't gonna be no playing. It's gonna be murder. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be like Nat Turner, 1831, up in this motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna happen.
That's crazy, man. In my opinion, the only hope that we kind of have left is music and vibrations. A lot of people don't understand how important it is. Sometimes I can like get behind a mic and I don't know what type of energy I'm gonna push out, where it comes from. Trip me out sometimes.
We ain't even really rapping. We're just letting our dead homies tell stories for us.
I wanted to read one last thing to you. It's actually something a good friend had wrote describing my world. It says, the caterpillar is a prisoner to the streets that conceived it. Its only job is to eat or consume everything around it in order to protect itself from this mad city. While consuming this environment, the caterpillar begins to notice ways to survive. One thing it notices is how much the world shuns him, but praises the butterfly. The butterfly represents the talent, the thoughtfulness, and the beauty within the caterpillar. But having a harsh outlook on life, the caterpillar sees the butterfly as weak and figures out a way to pimp it to his own benefits. Already surrounded by this mad city, the caterpillar goes to work on the cocoon, which institutionalizes him. He can no longer see past his own thoughts. He's trapped. While trapped inside these walls, certain ideas take root, such as going home and bringing back new concepts to this mad city. The result? Wings begin to emerge, breaking the cycle of feeling stagnant. Finally free, the butterfly sheds light on situations that the caterpillar never considered, ending the internal struggle. Although the butterfly and caterpillar are completely different, they are one and the same.